السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. The most prominent and most used argument of theists, those who believe in a God and in a creator, against atheists, those who don't believe that there is a God in existence or a creator. One of the strongest, if not the strongest argument that is used is that there is a design in play. And this design is too organized for it to be random. And what that means essentially is that there are too many natural laws for this to be the consequence of a random act. An explosion, even if it's a very sophisticated and full of elements and details and science, there are too many laws for this universe to be the consequence or the result of an implosion or an explosion. And therefore, the design that we see is an indicator that there is someone who designed it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is without a doubt the strongest, or perhaps it is the strongest argument there, and it is an argument the Quran uses quite a bit. Now, the atheist will come and say, sure, there is a design, and there's a lot of good in that design, it's beneficial, but there's also bad design. Meaning there are certain things in existence that govern our world or our universe that is simply bad. We could do better without it. Such as cancer, such as our wisdom teeth. We know no use for our wisdom teeth, and therefore it's what they call a bad design. Now, for some of their examples, the explanation is that you considering this a bad design is not because in of itself it is a bad design, or that it's inconsistent with a design, but rather your understanding of what the design is what's wrong. So for an atheist, there's nothing beyond this life. There is no afterlife. And therefore, something like cancer destroys a person's life, and it harms the life of their family members. And this is inconsistent with the pursuit of a human being, and that is their well-being in this life. Now, Islam doesn't deny that we as human beings should live well, but Islam adds an extra depth, an extra dimension to the way we understand the design of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is, there is a next life. This life is not meant to be the ends all, be all. And therefore, something like cancer isn't a bad design, it's an unfortunate tribulation, it's a test, and it can lead to the greatest musibah, the greatest calamity, and that is death. But when you look at the design, including the next life, what you find is that cancer, for example, will be a source of expiation for the individual, a source of good deeds for the individual. It will help them in the next life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards them for all the pain and all the patience and all the stress that they go through. So when you look at the design in its complete form, you find that although cancer is something harmful to this world in the overall scheme of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's design, it's not all negative. There's a lot of good that comes to the believer if they are patient. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us long lives and healthy lives as well, inshallah. Ameen. The other examples will focus on what science has yet to discover to be something useful or good. Like wisdom teeth. What's the point? If this design is so sophisticated and created and designed by a perfect being, subhanahu wa ta'ala, then why did he create this imperfection? This right here. Now, a very simple answer can be science has yet to understand the role of wisdom teeth. That's fine. But in Surah Al-Muddathir, which is coming up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a very interesting point. In a set of verses in this chapter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that He has designated 19 gatekeepers to hellfire. 19. Very strange number. Why 19? We as human beings were curious. Well, why 19? What's the wisdom behind it? And people might try and contemplate because of this and because of that. But, you know, it just seems like a very random number. Why 19? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the verse that follows, عَلَيْهَا تِسْعَةَ عَشَرَ Upon it are 19 gatekeepers. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ إِلَّا مَلَائِكَةً وَمَا جَعَلْنَا عِدَّتَهُمْ إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِيَسْتَيْقِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِيَسْتَيْقِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ وَيَزْدَادَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا وَلَا يَرْتَابَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَلِيَقُولَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ وَالْكَافِرُونَ مَاذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِهَذَا مَثَلًا To just paraphrase for the sake of time, essentially Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the number wasn't made, or the wisdom behind the number isn't necessarily a scientific wisdom, but rather it is a spiritual wisdom. And that is, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does what seems to us to be very random or irrelevant or inconsistent to us as we see it, because we don't fully understand it, what this does is it has a reaction to our hearts. It creates a reaction in our hearts, in our spirituality, in our iman. For some people, when they see this seemingly random reality, for the believers, it increases their iman. Subhanallah. For some people of the book, it actually brings to them a certitude that Islam is the truth and they enter Islam because of it. And for some people whose hearts doubt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it leads to spiritual problems. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us that the wisdom is not in the science behind it, but rather in the spirituality behind it. Sometimes there are things we don't quite understand. I'm not talking about events in our lives, but rather I'm talking about the design that we see around us. Why are there wisdom teeth? What's the point of this? Well, perhaps the point is not a scientific need for it, but rather a spiritual need for it. And that is to accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation, or the way Allah created the creation. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created it. And essentially what this does for us is it brings us a solace that if I don't understand everything in the world, that's okay. I understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who's governing it. And Allah is perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This doesn't mean we sit back and relax and we don't be proactive in learning and studying. Perhaps something in the wisdom tooth can be discovered that is very beneficial to mankind, that can save many lives. Imagine being someone who discovers that, and now all the lives that are saved because of your efforts, your discovery, your sacrifices are in your book of deeds. So, but until we discover that, until we understand it more, it is okay to not understand something, so long as we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who did it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this brings us an amount of solace. We don't need to know everything, although we should pursue it. We should try and understand. But until then, we feel at peace, we feel at solace, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one in control, is the one who is going to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one in control, right, is enough for me to appreciate all that's going on and bring solace to my heart. And also to appreciate that if that doesn't do something for you, there are other people who it's benefiting them. Right? And therefore the world isn't about us, isn't about the individual, but rather about all of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring that peace and solace to our hearts and to grant us the wisdom and the insight to better appreciate His design and His creation. Ameen. Just a few announcements, inshallah. Perhaps you've seen the flyer that Someone requested, gave us a suggestion that on Eid Day, we do a drive-through where we can, you know, people can see each other and we can continue the tradition of OCIF on Eid morning after a prayer. We have donuts and we have some sweets that we offer people. So inshallah, we answer the call, and the board has been working very hard to organize everything. Alhamdulillah, we got the permit from the police department. We have reserved the donuts and we have reserved the sweets as well. We're just waiting to see your faces, inshallah. So check the OCIF website. There are instructions, because the police department did not allow us to use both lanes of the road because that would create a blockage. And therefore, there are one way, there are two roads, but going one way where there will be stations. So please look at the map and understand that and be patient with us. We're expecting a large turnout. So don't get frustrated. Don't feel like, oh, I have to wait in line and I'm just going to go home. Just come and see us, inshallah. Also, tomorrow is the Khatmul Quran, and we will be joined by Sheikh Yasir for a special nightly reflection. Please continue to support the masjid. If you haven't given Zakat al-Fitra or Zakat al-Mal, please go ahead and do that ASAP so that we can distribute the money as soon as Eid comes, so that all families can enjoy themselves that day. So we hope to see you for these events, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.